1.
Un papo le cinque.
About the physical side, now I'm in a good moment, but of course still far from my normal level. I start to do some running, cycling, but yeah, especially about cardio and left arm, legs are okay, but about the right arm still we need to do some big steps. Yeah, mental side was hard on the beginning because you know nothing to do at home. The days, the hours were very long. But now we have like a planning during all the day. We do two sessions physio and then we also training at gym. The moment where I suffer more is the race weekend. Because watching the race, all the practice, the races from the TV is not easy. Yeah, I started cycling and running, and I expect much worse because you know, was like 4 or 5 weeks completely just on the sofa watching the TV. But I started running, and immediately from the first day I feel good. On the first week also I improve something, cycling too. The most important is that I have all the movement, and yeah, now step by step with the physio Carlos, he's living with me in my house, and we will start to work hard to do that the correct steps in the correct time. I was surprised because normally my pace on running is 350 minutes per kilometer, and yeah, I did 4:10 per kilometer, so it was a good pace. The next day I was destroyed. Yeah, of course, Repsol on the team is and was and is, I think, in a difficult situation. You know, when I feel important there, and I feel that we can achieve many good results. But when you have a rookie rider on the other part of the garage, one rider just I was out from the first race, and then you can miss a little bit the way. But now looks like. It's normal. A rookie have a process, and my teammate and he's my brother, of course, he has a good process. But was important, I think I speak with the team too, and I think the when Tuesday test in Misano was very important because they found something there. One important thing for the rookie riders is the second that they have two races in a row in the same circuit. This helps a lot. The most difficult thing in MotoGP is to arrive in a new circuit. It's not a new circuit, but it's a new circuit with a MotoGP bike, and then all the things change. Of course, I try to help Alex, and I try on Thursday when they have the tire allocation. He sent me the photo, and I try to, you know, give some advice. And yeah, but then we have like a rule. He need to work with his team. We must to be professional, and he's working with his team. 3 months. You know, are a lot, of course are a lot, but is the when I was in the doctors, we find a different, we try to understand or to listen to different opinions, different doctors, and yeah, they say around 3 months. So in which moment, I don't know. I know that I'm closer to be on a bike, that is the most important. It's strange because it looks like nobody wanna win, nobody wanna be the top. You know, one thing is be, you know, a rider that, yeah, if you win will be fantastic, and if you win will be something incredible. But when you are the rider that need to win, then it's changing something. And it's changing something that you have much more doubts because you don't know if attack, if defend. If you take the last 10 years, Honda did a perfect strategy. Why? Because it's the team that won more titles, more team title and team championship and more construction championship. So I think Honda is doing a great job during all these years. It's true that 1 year, you know, every manufacturer is struggling a lot 1 year, but now is like this. Every MotoGP have a different characters, and then the rider must to adapt to the bike. And Honda have the philosophy during all his many years in 500cc in MotoGP, because for example, when I speak with Doohan, with Cribillet, the philosophy was the same. Honda have a good bike, but you need to be 100% fit, you need to push a lot the bike, but then when you get the feeling with the bike, you can be really fast. Now it will be interesting to finish the season in Portimao. I hope to be there. I hope to race there with the MotoGP, because I tested there with a Moto2 bike in 2012, a long time ago, but I remember the circuit and was very nice. Just say thanks especially to all Repsol Honda team, and also to all the fans that I received many great messages. I mean, I read many questions when you will come back. I don't know when I will come back. I hope to come back as soon as possible. I feel that it's more soon than late, so this is something good also, and yeah. Let's see, but anyway, thanks to keep to supporting me, supporting Honda, and yeah, don't worry that we will come back to the top.